Hello everybody, welcome to Deluxe Collectibles, and today I'm going to be discussing an interesting topic regarding LEGO Ninjago, the Island, and Seabound, and I want to discuss how they formatted the season as a whole, because they are sort of connected to each other, and I wanted to just sort of discuss how they managed to do that, and also if I think they should go forward with that sort of format in future seasons. So of course, the way that the Island and Seabound connect, I consider the Island almost as a prelude to the actual Seabound season, and they aren't technically the same season, even though on my own channel I do label the reactions and reviews for the Island as season 14 and then Seabound as season 15, but they are technically speaking the same season in terms of how LEGO categorizes them officially. So I kind of consider the Island a prelude to Seabound, and I just want to kind of talk about how I think that formatting sort of worked. So of course, with the Island, I think it gave it a great opportunity for us to get another smaller Ninjago wave ahead of Seabound, because now we've seen the full reveal for the Seabound wave, and it is a very large wave. We're getting quite a few sets within the actual wave, some large ones as well, so I feel like that works really well, because that is of course the larger like part of the season, of course, with 16 episodes. And then of course we saw with the Island it just being comprised of 4 episodes, almost being considered like a mini movie of sorts, so I think that worked really well for it. And then we got just a couple of sets for that that were amazing on their own, and that also gave us the opportunity to get different sort of outfits for the ninja as well, different builds, travel to a different location, and then it still kind of set up the overarching story of Seabound just in a minor way, while still exploring its own self-contained story as well with the Keepers and Wojira, but then still kind of hinting and foreshadowing towards the future season or the future part of the season as in Seabound. And I think that honestly worked really well, because I've been thinking a lot about of course how Ninjago has its featured sort of ninja. Of course, I think this works really well, especially for the marketing of the LEGO sets, because then you're putting one ninja on the box art there, you're really promoting them quite a bit, and definitely within the context of the show, you're giving them a lot more character growth and depth to them. So I love it for that reason, but I think it's also interesting to kind of split it up between the ninja as well, because coming out of Seabound now, processing my thoughts on it, I absolutely love the character growth that we get for Nia and sort of the somewhat conclusion to her character's journey as well in some sort of sense. But I thought that was really well done, but I feel like at the same time, not that the other ninja get neglected, it's not necessarily the correct word for that, but I just felt like they could have been a bit more involved. And even though they are technically, I feel like they start at one point in the story and then end off at the same point just story-wise. And I feel like Nia had a ton of growth, and I think that worked really well. But I think the other ninja also have other opportunities, and I think they could maybe kind of utilize that, splitting a season between two of the ninja. I know we saw this kind of being experimented with, not even specifically with a ninja, but more so in season 11, of course, where it was split up between the fire and the ice chapters, and I think that was very interesting. Even though I know it's not like everybody's favorite season, I don't mind it honestly, but I think it's great to kind of see LEGO experiment with those sort of storytelling techniques, because it can make for a really interesting season and very experimental as well, and I think they're bound to nail it at some point. And I think Seabound was fantastic, but I think kind of the way that the Island and Seabound converged together could kind of be worked on as well. But I think it did work with having the Island kind of being self-contained, but it didn't necessarily further a ninja story specifically, so I think maybe they could use it more for the purposes of that in particular, because even though I love the Keepers, I love their introduction, I like their role within the Island, I feel like they were still a little bit underused even when they returned in Seabound. I felt that way also, so it kind of felt like, yes, you're bringing in these cool characters, but you're not really using them to their full potential. So I almost would have rather have more time developed for one of like the mainstay characters, of course, one of the ninja, because I always think it's good to constantly keep developing those characters and showing more of their dimensions to their personalities as well. So I feel like that could kind of be worked on. I'm still, of course, very satisfied with the Island and Seabound. They're like two of my favorite things in Ninjago, especially recently. They've been fantastic. I mean, I'm not much of like a complainer when it comes to Ninjago stuff. I'm sure, of course, you can find nitpicks and everything, but I think that it still worked together really well, and I want to see LEGO kind of continue to experiment with this idea of having a prelude like this ahead of the actual, like, full story for the season. So I think that's really interesting. I feel like they can really grow a lot with the characters in that way and give us interesting stories that can tie in, because then in Seabound, when you see the ninja return to the Keeper's Island, it's like, wow, we're back at this really cool location that we saw earlier on, where if we hadn't had that prelude with those characters, it would have just been like, it's still cool, we're going to this new location, but there's no familiarity with that location. So I think that it would just be really cool to kind of, I don't know, just expand upon that sort of idea of the prelude and then connect it more intertwined with the actual season. So I feel like that would be an interesting direction to go, kind of focus on the ninja, maybe telling more than just one singular character story within it. But who knows what they're going to do. I'm sure it's going to be absolutely amazing. I was very, very satisfied with Seabound. I would say overly satisfied. It just hit my expectations and then went through the roof above that. So it was fantastic. I mean, they're blowing me away with the storytelling that they're doing, but I just want to see them experiment as well, similar to what they do with the animation style, with like the reimagined shorts and things like that. I think there's other things they can do as well, but I'm sure they've got it all planned out really well. But I like to see them experiment as well, also because I'm such a big fan of the actual product line for Ninjago from LEGO. I think that it just gives us more opportunities for even more sets as well, like the island and Seabound being split up with that. So it's very cool. It's really interesting way of telling the stories, and I like how they're evolving their sort of strategies with that. So those are just kind of my thoughts on this topic here. Let me know yours down below in the comment section. Do you want to see seasons like this where we kind of get a prelude to the actual season? Do you want to see them separately split up, similar to the fire and ice chapters? Or how do you want to see Ninjago sort of done in the future? Do you want to see it focusing on one sole ninja? Or would you rather have it kind of split between a few ninja, two ninja? I did do a separate video, which I'll link at the end of this one, where I did discuss who's going to be the main ninja for the next season. And I talked about a little bit about splitting it between Kai and Jay, because they're, of course, very closely connected to Nia. So I feel like there's a lot of evolution and growth that they could both go through. So you could be sure to check out that video if you're interested in that topic. But for now, thanks so much for watching this. Let me know all of your thoughts and opinions down below. And if you did enjoy, be sure to leave a like, also subscribe as well. It is highly appreciated. So thank you so much. I will see you all next time, and always remember, keep on collecting.